Okay, good afternoon. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Alhamdulillah, hirobbil alamin.
Waalaikumsalam.
Wassalatu wassalamu ala asrofil amyai wal mursalin wal ahlihi wa ashabihi ajmain. Okay, thank you for the opportunity with the representative from MMSA, or what is the long name of MMSA actually? Okay.
MMSA is Muhammadiyah Medical Students Activities.
Okay. Before we begin, let's introduce ourselves from MMSA. First with Mbak Indi, and then from there's Mas Afif. And then my group partner, Mbak Ananda Putri. So in this video, in this interview, we will ask some questions actually for our guests from MMSA or Muhammadiyah Medical what agency, sorry, Muhammadiyah.
Students activities.
Oh yeah. Okay. Okay. First question, maybe. What is actually this MMSA organization?
Okay. So as my friends told me before, that MMSA stands for Muhammadiyah Medical Students Activities. So MMSA is one of the student activity, or maybe we know it as UKM, Unit Kegiatan Mahasiswa, in Faculty of Medicine and Health Science in Universitas Muhammadiyah Yogyakarta. We are non-profit and non-government organization that is independent, nationalist, non-politic, and also non-partisan with activity-based program. And we also have a motto, maybe, that is active. And active itself stands for activity-based, tech-based, international-based, and also accommodative-based. Oh, okay. So actually, as I mentioned before, that MMSA is a non-profit and non-government organization. We are not under any particular company and do not take sides with any institution, but we have an affiliation in international and also national level. In national level, we have an affiliation with CIMSA, our Center for Indonesian Medical Students Activities. Have an affiliation with IFMSA, or International Federation of Medical Students Association. That is the biggest students organization in the world who has been recognized by the United Nations.
If we may know, how can MMS be formed?
Okay, MMSA or Muhammadiyah Medical Student Activities was established on December 26, 2002 in Yogyakarta. Difficult in the bureaucracy and the desire to optimize potential and activities as medical student result in an idea from a group of students to form a new platform that could accommodate their creativity, so that a medical student activity form. In the implementation of its organization, MMSA FKK UNB, which is a medical student organization, accommodate various activities, especially in the fields of education, international student exchange for profession and research, public health, and community service.
Are there any divisions formed in MMSA?
of course, is or in other organization now it as division. Its steering committee has its own focus. There are MECO or Medical Education Committee, and then PSCO, Public Health Committee, RACO, Reproductive Health and Rights, including HIV/AIDS Committee, RDCO, Human Rights and Peace Committee, RECO, Data Exchange Committee, and then the last, SECO. SECO is a Student Exchange Committee.
Oh, so there's a exchange for this organization.
Yeah, we also facilitate our members or FKIK students to do the this that facilitates the members to do the exchange. The first one is RECO, Research Exchange Committee, and the second one is SECO, Student Exchange Committee. Two of this Senate Committee is facilitating the exchange, but in the different field. The RECO is for research exchange, so we can do some research the other
country.
Sorry, I didn't get the
other country. And then for the Senate Exchange Committee is facilitating the professional exchange. So maybe the students knows it. We will do like for us. We know it as. Yeah, in the different countries.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Is there like any program that that established by this organization that MS established except the exchange?
Okay. MSA and our six Senate committees are united to support and realize 4 points of the Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs. There are point 3, good health and well-being, point 4, quality education, point 5, gender equality, point 13, climate change. And this, we, and maybe if we mention one by one of our activities in each Senate committee, there will be a lot. Maybe we will mention our flagship projects, flagship programs. We have two. The first one is ComDev, our community development, is our long-term project that aims to make a community independent. So this program is implemented for minimum 4 years with a planned focus. This year we have succeeded in establishing the Dusun Semenkarang through ComDev Dusun Semenkarang through ComDev atmosphere with a focus on hypertension. And we also now processing to establishing the Dusun Watu through ComDev Aries, which has focus on diabetes. And also now we are initiating a new ComDev, that is ComDev Medico, in Dusun Ngasem with focus on diarrhea and healthy lifestyle. And the second one is ITMSS, or International Tropical Medicine Summer School. This is one of our flagship projects since 2005. And this program focuses on tropical diseases such as malaria, tuberculosis, dengue, high fever, and so on. And this program is divided into two major categories. there are educational programs and non-educational programs. Maybe my friends will mention about the educational and non-educational program.
Okay, I'm sorry, question is a bit. Okay, for educational program, lecture activities, skill lab, practice and tutorial. There is also a community work in the form of hands-on practice in the general public to practice medical analysis and life examination. Clinical visit to a hospital related to looking for real case and also examination and then non-educational coming ceremony, farewell ceremony, international night, dance training, cooking class and music class, and then also social program visit to several rural Jakarta. Example is Borobudur, Prambanan, Alun-Alun, and then where?
For the interesting program that has been mentioned, has MMS ever
receive an award from a particular institution, like award or something? Okay, we had been received two awards. Wait. Okay. The first one, we have Rekor Muri for 22,000 puzzle Kita Autisme on July 2013. And then Kimsa also nominated as Indonesia MBGs Award in 2012-2013. And also Rekor Muri for Pita AIDS in 2015.
Okay. Interesting.
Okay, maybe I want to add something because we know that now we are all facing the pandemic era. So MMSA is also do some adaptation for their activities. In the past, we do it like in the real with in the community and the but we know that we can do it now, so we make all of our programs online. We do like some webinar and we make a lot of webinars to keep raising to empowering our medical students and also improving our nation's health.
Okay, I think last thing, is there any messages that you want to share, especially for our viewers in our ages, I think, in this hard time?
Okay, maybe I don't want to talk that much, but I hope everyone of you who watching this, we know that this is hard time for us, but we can do a lot of things. The one that we can do is just protect ourselves, just do not go anywhere. If it is not that important, please just stay at home and wear your mask, and then protecting yourself, you protect your family too. So please mean that.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, I think that's all from us, Mbak Sidi and Mas Afif. We totally appreciate the chance that you give for us to interview the MMSA organization. So thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you, Kak.
Okay, that's all from us. Undur makola wa tandur makola. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.